So let's look at how the processor sees the memory. The processor sees what we call physical memory, which is the memory contained in the actual memory modules that we bought and put in the system. The amount of that memory is sometimes even lower than 4 gigabytes. It is almost never 4 gigabytes per process that we have in the system, because there can be tens or even hundreds of processes in a modern operating system. And it is never 16 exabytes per process. This is how much memory we need if we have 2 to the 64th memory locations, which is what you would have with a 64-bit address. So if each process in a 64-bit machine thinks it has this much memory, there is just no way we can have enough actual memory for that. So we conclude that the amount of physical memory we have is usually less than what all the programs can access. If all the programs access all the memory they possibly can, they will access much, much more than the memory we actually have. The addresses that the processor uses for the physical memory have a one-to-one mapping to the bytes or words in the physical memory. So a given address always goes to the same physical location, and the physical location always has exactly one physical address.